Now with what you should know about masks. You know, the face coverings are essential for the new normal and one of the ways we can help protect our neighbors. Becky Worley joins us from San Francisco with how to shop for one. Good morning there, Becky. How you doing?
Good morning, Robert. I'm doing well, but not all masks are created equal, so buying one is a challenge. What they're made of, how they fit, and how you care for them all affect their usefulness.
The surgical pleat, the adjustable, even the mask accessory, but
that's not always one size fits all.
Look online and you'll see Instagram and Etsy overflowing with them. Big name fashion brands customizing them.
They fit most size adults, small, medium, large, extra large. It helps with the adjustable straps.
And many touting the comfort and efficacy of masks for sale. The CDC advising all masks should allow for breathing without restriction, fit snugly but comfortably, and include multiple layers of fabric which can help prevent the spread of the virus.
Tightly woven cotton cloth, something approximating the weave of a bandana, certainly not a looser weave like the kind of material or knit that a sweater is made out of. The holes in that type of material are much too large.
But anything too thick can restrict breathing.
So the sweet spot is actually to find one that's comfortable and breathable enough that you're not taking it on and off and touching your face.
Soft ear loops or adjustable bands can make a big difference. Many come with bendable wire over the nose bridge.
Some of the best things that you can do are to make sure that the mask fits closely on your face. If the mask is fitting improperly, air is actually being funneled downward and inward on the sides of the mask, directly into the nostrils and into the nasal passages. And that's exactly what we don't want.
Now for some mask don'ts. Noble says don't go more than a day or two without cleaning it. The washing machine and a thorough dry are key. And while you might opt for something cute like sequins or glitter, our expert doesn't recommend those, as they can make fabric more porous, can harbor bacteria more than cloth, and be itchy so we touch our face more.
Two-ply cotton of a tight weave, think high thread count sheets, is one of the best fabrics for masks. One way to test is to hold it up to the light or the sky, and if you see light through it, it's probably too porous. The less transparency, the better, Robin. Even on a cloudy day, I could see this one was just not up to snuff.
Wow. Oh, it's a great idea to hold it up to the light like that. Hey, Becky, what do you think about those neck gaiter-style coverings that we're seeing so much of?
I see a lot of guys especially wearing these. Now, these are designed to be breathable for sports or outdoor activities. So experts worry they can be too porous as well. Some, you know, really made for that breathability. Out here in California also, it's warm and these things are getting hot. This is going to get harder as summer sets in.
Probably so. All right, Becky, thank you so much. Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.